is Ioana-Teodora Tica, Alexandru-Corneliu, Olteanu și Emil Racec, supporting multiple programming languages in an online judge. You have the floor, Teodora.
Hi, can everybody hear me and see my screen?
Yes, okay. I can.
Hello everyone, my name is Teodora. I am a master's student at the Polytechnic University of Bucharest, and today I'll talk about online judges. We'll explore their main features, see why they're good learning and teaching tools, and how we could also potentially improve them. To start off, online judges are web-based platforms for coding challenges. They provide automatic evaluation of source code, binaries, or even textual solutions to programming challenges. And they are good learning and teaching tools because students can use them as a practice ground for either exams, interviews, or competitive programming contests, while the teachers can use an online judge as an automatic assessment solution, which can optimize the process of homework grading. Here we have an example. This is how a problem on LeetCode looks. We can see that on the left side, we have the problem statement, while on the right side, we have a coding editor. And here, there are a few really important features for the user. First, we can see that the user has the opportunity to choose the language of choice. Then in the editor, we have some code snippets which help the user to structure his or her solution. And then at the bottom, we can run and test the code we wrote, so we get immediate validation for our solution. And these are only a few of the features that many online judges offer. But there are also a few limitations, especially from the point of view of the teacher, because widely available online judges, so the one developed by standalone companies, they don't allow teachers to be problem curators, so to introduce custom challenges. The online judges, the structure they provide is generally suited for problems which are focused on either algorithms or data structures, so only a small set of subjects that we study in computer science. And also, they are not really suited for the complex assignment a student would get as a homework, but only for the type of problems he or she would have to solve either in an exam or in a lab setting. These types of limitations have encouraged us to come up with our own online judge, which would provide further flexibility to both our teachers and our students. So we want to make Lambda Checker, our online judge, to be suitable for homework assignments, for exams, and for lab exercises. We strive to go beyond simple test-based grading, so we would like to introduce code inspections to validate either proper solution design. For example, in the object-oriented class, we would like people to use design patterns. And we would also like to assess automatically the complexity of a solution. And for our students, we would like to provide features which would improve their productivity, such as coding style checks and linters to happen real time as they type their solution. But before we get to such features which are advanced, we have to first look at something more basic, and that is supporting multiple languages in our online judge. The motivation behind having more languages is obviously flexibility, which counts for both students and teachers. A student maybe wants to choose when he practices for a competition, he wants to choose the language in which he or she wants to code, while the teacher might want to reuse the same assignment for different classes, and different classes might be based on different programming languages. And when we want to introduce multiple languages in an online judge, there are two main concerns. First, we have to integrate the compiler for each language. And second, we would need to provide code snippets for the problems in each supported language. The first problem has been previously addressed, so we choose to focus only on the second one. And just to iterate why code snippets, although small usually, are actually really important, they help students focus only on the problem, so they don't have to spend time on parsing the input. They just need to come up with their solution, and teachers can use the code snippets to impose a structure for the solution that the students provide. This means that we would like to be able to introduce only once the code snippet and then have it in every language which is supported in our online judge, because introducing them by hand is both cumbersome and error prone. So if we want to do this automatically, we have two challenges. We need to answer the question how we want to provide the code snippets and how we will actually translate them from a language to another. To the first question, we identified two potential solutions. We could either use a custom-made domain-specific language. As a short definition, a domain-specific language is a program language suited only to describe the tasks which are specific to a domain. While a general purpose language such as Java, C++, or C, they can be used to describe any type of problem. As an example, HTML can be viewed as DSL. And then for the second question, how we could translate the code snippet from a language to another, we would use a transpiler. To explain what a transpiler is, a compiler usually is a program which takes code written in a high-level language and translates it to a low-level language. The transpiler will take the source code written in high-level language and translate it to another high-level language. And now let's see what would be the advantages and disadvantages of the two solutions we identified for providing our input. If we were to provide it through a domain-specific language, the main advantage would be the fact that the people who designed the assignments, they wouldn't really focus. They would be able to better separate the problem from the specific language concern, and it would restrict the use of language-specific features, which might make the skeleton code way too complicated in certain situations. It would also help imposing a coding style across all challenges found on our online judge, because obviously. Because we generate automatically the code snippets, we can fully control the end result. And last but not least, this model would be potentially easier to validate because domain-specific language are a great tool to model abstract problems. The main disadvantages would be, obviously, we need to define a new syntax and we need to also implement all the tools for it, so parsers, compilers. People will need to learn the new syntax, and some might be reluctant to do so. And also, in some cases, the domain-specific language might produce some code snippets with lack expressiveness. And this obviously would not be suited, especially when the aim of a class is that the students learn a specific language and not just how to address algorithmic or data structure related problems. Now, for the other solution, providing the code snippets through a general purpose language, This is obviously easy for everyone because most people already know at least one language. It is obviously best suited when the aim of the coding class is learning the new is learning a new language. And then in terms of how to implement our system, it provides the benefit that we could reuse certain components such as the parsers. We can reuse those for other features that we want to introduce in our online judge, such as the syntax highlight, linters, or other code analysis features. The disadvantage is that a parser needs to be built for every language, and this provides added complexity. And there are some features of a language which are not easy to translate to another one. So for example, in C++, we have pointers and references. In Java, we don't have the opportunity to access memory directly. We only use references. In the process of implementing a proof of concept for our system, we discovered that mixing the two approaches might actually have more advantages apart from combining the ones of the each solution, but it would also help us implement a system which is easy to use and easy to maintain. And I tried to sketch in this diagram, I tried to sketch what would be the workflow of this mixed approach. So let's say that we provide the problem specification in a certain language. We will have a facade which will use the parser for the problem specification. It will provide a complex abstract syntax tree which describes the structure of the code snippets, which we then analyze. We extract only the important information. We represent it through an internal representation, which in our case would be domain-specific language. Then we parse this internal representation. We will get a general AST which describes just the structure of the code without any features specific to the language it comes from. And then when we want to generate the same code snippets in the other languages, we will decorate this very general abstract syntax tree with whatever components are specific to the new languages. And then we will use this decorated AST to generate the final code. At the moment, we have a proof of concept tool which performs the translation from Java to C++ and to C++ and vice versa. And in our next steps, we want to design the DSL, which will act as the internal representation integrated in our current solution. And then comes the part when we actually use this into the wild and give it to the students and the teachers to try it out and see what are their complaints and their feedback. And after we will polish off the proof of concept solution, we can then start to include new languages which might be desired for other classes. In conclusion, online judges are good tools for practicing computer science, and there are yet ways in which they can be improved so that they're best suited for the learning for the academic environment of a classroom where both teachers and students can benefit from them. If there is any time left, I hope there are questions, and if not, these are the emails where you can send us feedback, questions, suggestions, anything you think would be helpful for us. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Teodora, for your presentation. Very good idea to have an online judge that is able to generate snippets in several languages. Any questions? because otherwise I have one or two questions on my own. So I will start, and maybe some other participants also have a question. My question is, is a process of generating snippets in different languages achievable and perfect? Like, which is a performance? Can you generate good snippets in any language using any of the two approaches that you have proposed? Because I think there are some challenges with both of them. Like, where would you stop? Like, which is something you consider good?
So to begin with, we will have to stop at the best effort solution both approaches have the same limitation. As you said, and I expect that you were thinking, there are certain things which are hard to impossible to translate from a language to another. In this case, in the first solution, if we were to use the DSL, it is easy. We define the DSL in such way that we only accept the features which we know that we can seamlessly translate in any language. And if we were to use just GPLs, we will probably need to have a set of recommendations saying that, so we can only support these features. In case you need to use something more, just please be aware that we will only be able to provide this much translation, and you might need to revise a bit the code after the automatic process.
Okay, perfect. And this was also like my suggestion or my idea to limit the grammar, the actual grammar of the DSL, or even for the domain-specific languages. Mm-hmm. For the general language, because if you limit the grammar, then you might have very good translations, of course not for any snippet, but for the snippets that you want to have very good translations, especially if you use them for education, you rather want good quality snippets than to translate everything with poor quality.
Mm-hmm. And at the moment, I didn't get to mention this, the features that we provide are class definition, function definition, method definition, also declarations. We can declare and assign variables. We have the basic control structures like if, while, for. We are still working on introducing some more features. We're still working on which are the very important ones and which are the nice to have ones.
Okay, perfect. Thank you, Teodora. Any other questions? Otherwise, thank you again for your presentation.
Thank you.
Any other questions, you can use the chat. And we're moving on to the